Because I was talking to Rick and Mark, Vince this morning. We have a problem. We have changed in a very systematic way from matter state to GANs, sorry, to nanomaterial. And then we've gone to the GANs, and now we developed into plasma, and now we only work in this. And there are people, as Rick said, got lost because we moved too fast. They moved with them for years, but some of you are still trying to understand this cross-section, some this cross-section, and some this. For some people to go from there to there is difficult, even to go from there to there is difficult. We've seen this from the beginning when we introduced the GANs and nano layers. It took time for people to understand it. So set yourself up in a way that people can and always leave room for them to extend to the next place. Universe works on this. Interaction of plasma, or what we call interaction of magnetic field, both having gravitational and magnetical, or gravitational and magnetical. So what happens when you have two plasmas, they interact, what you like to see, South Pole, North Pole, that you understand. For those who have a problem with the plasma, there is no difference between the plasma than a GANs, than a nanomaterial. It's just the GANs and a nanomaterial and a matter state are the condition in the atmospheric condition. So what you are used to is atmospheric and tangibility. And if you're comfortable with that, you stay there. If you want to extend the plasma technology or understanding the work of the universe, we go to a condition that there is no tangibility or visibility. What is the problem? A lot of you have, and a lot of people who come into the understanding of this technology is, okay, we had the copper, we see it, we can feel it. We had a nanomaterial in our hand, we see the black stuff. We came to GANs, we can see it, but we feel it, we draw it, we can touch it, so we accept it in a way. But with the plasma is the same GANs. Now it enters into the atmospheric condition of the Earth, it enters the atmospheric condition of the universe. That's where the difference is. We enter not pressures and temperatures of condition of this planet, we enter the performance of the same atomic structure in the plasma in the condition of the universe. And this is where most of you get lost. How come is this? How come is that? It's very much having a bowl of soup in the fridge or outside, in the freezer or outside. It's still the same soup. Nothing has changed. It's just in the freezer, it's solid, outside is liquid. Plasma in a GANs state has a physical appearance in a condition of Earth condition. In a vacuum condition, it's still a plasma, but it behaves exactly the same, but in a much more freer condition. It means when you see the GANs, it is a coil, it's green, white, whatever you're used to it by now. Here, the plasma is free. It depends on the eye of the beholder to see its color, according to gravitational magnetic field of the environment of the universe. If you look and poke into the blood vessel, blood is not red in the blood vessel because it's in a vacuum condition. When it's in touch with the atmospheric, it becomes red. So you are already used to, it's part of your own structure. It's just that you have not been aware of it. When we poke into a blood vessel, In a vacuum condition, you look into it not as a matter, you won't see red. Red appears when it's in contact on the Earth's gravitational condition, even though we see it as a blood vessels, even our blood vessels are red, they look dark. Internally, they are not. So, plasma has its own condition, we are used to it, it's part of us. But now, the body is in a vacuum condition, where us, as a human, have made a containment of it, we call it our physical body, with two legs and two arms. In a space, now, the two legs and two arms is the totality of the universe. But the interaction of the magnetic gravitational field does not change. It's still the same. The ones who are gravitational, in becoming or linking up with another, they link up with magnetical. That's what it is. One gives and the other one takes. Where at this point is magnetical for one, becomes gravitational for the other, and as it goes through and it spreads out, it is magnetical, which means it spreads out, and it has to be attracted by somewhere, which is gravitational, it has to be gravitated to. In the body of a man, is confinement of the skin. In the universe is openness of the universe. And as in our teachings we said, if you have the universal shape, in any shape or form you consider it to be, as we have the central line of the universe, as we were teaching yesterday, everything has come from the central line of the universe, what we call the principal line. And has spread it out into the span of the universal or unicos. So the balloon, as it's released, and the environment of the unicos allows it, the universe opens up into the spans as it has. It's like a gas. Gas take the shape and the size of its container. So does plasma. As long as the other conditions allow it, it expands to the line and the limit of the strength. So if you are a human cell here on Earth, you originally started from this line. So, the other fields which run across the universe, which all started from there, you have connection with everything. Because magnetic fields, even fine, very weak, they all have all their connections. It's the mother which has the connection with the child, doesn't matter where the child goes, because it's starts from the, and as it goes through the process and it divides to a weaker or subdivision of the smaller packages, becomes different things in different part of the universe. And as you get closer, you have a higher strength gravitational magnetic fields. So, as is with the plasma, as we thought up to now, as you go to the center, the strength both in gravitational and magnetic field increases. So does in the universal condition. It's the same thing. So, those who have a problem and they think nanomaterial is a new thing, and those who have moved into the nano to the gas and they think the gas is a new thing, there is another step on top of the plasma, which is itself in a matter state condition, we call it GANS, in a free state of the universe, we call it a plasma. Sun is a plasma. Earth is a plasma in the openness of the universe. So, what happens, whatever the Earth has gravitational magnetic field releases or absorbs, has come from somewhere in the universe. And because we are very a small entity compared to the sun, most of our connection goes to our mother. Because we were created out of the fields of the mother. So, there should be no confusion, there should be no loss, as Rick was said, now you start talking about the plasma, a lot of people are getting lost. There is no loss, it's just, it took for you to understand In a very simple system, maybe we can rephrase it. You had the copper wire. It was conditioned as a matter state to molecular, as we say, tightness, that you could physically carry the wire around with you. We created the heat condition, which creates not the heat, but it creates a release or loosening of the magnetic gravitational fields, and we manage to see the molecular structure to be separated to atomic, what we call nano. And as we saw the nano layers, they became black, and we know it's there because copper was copper color and this was black. So we knew we achieved it. We then again changed the environment, because if you look at it, now you have a new material. Before you had copper black, copper color, now you have nano material which is black. So your new containment looked black. Then we added a new environment, of what we call sodium with chlorine plus water, which became a new box. Now you have a new entity. This new entity has become what you call GANS, much looser, at its own freedom. But as it came from here, it has a new dimension. So much looser, tight, is still connected, but a bit looser. A new condition of salt, now you created a new box. Here you saw the matter, here you saw superconductivity, here you see release of energy. Now what we are going to is the development of the science, understanding Fred in operation, and literally you come to a new box. And this is your new box, the plasma. Here, Earth condition, here, atmospheric, universal. So all your boxes come to be in it. That's as simple as it is. So there should be no losses in understanding. It's just now the box stuff moving from confinement of a copper wire to top of the copper wire, then in the water, now you work in the environment of the universe. There is another step after this. Man is blind because the knowledge is not transferred. This level about plasma condition of the universe, in time, man in the space will see. So, at this moment, those who got lost should not be lost. They just should understand this simple framework. You change the environment, put it this way, if it's very hard, in a matter state, you had a solid, you heat it up or change the pressure, it became liquid, you heat it up or change the pressure, became vapor or a gas, and if you heat up to condition of furthermore, the gas become loose, that each one plays as a star. That's all it is. There should be no loss, there should be no confusion. It is change of environment. We change the environment here by heat to this. You expect with the heat, liquidity and what you call vapor, but because we chose the right temperature, pressure in the confinement of the gravitational magnetic field of caustic, we managed to still hold on to. You didn't see the liquid because this is what you were used to. You're still the atomic structure, but close to each other, not lucid. And then here, you were expecting to see vapor. But because again we chose the same sodium configuration, because sodium is the linking element on this planet, instead of you getting vapor, you start seeing entities, you call it gans. In the matter of the universe, we don't have the sodium. We have the pressure, gravitational, magnetic field of the universe. And that's what you see plasma. There is no difference. A plasma of a molecular copper to the plasma of a free in a condition of the universe. Interaction is the same, attraction is the same. Where you were confined to be matter, you became loose, that you could become allowing a further steps that you could see more of. You're released to be in a gas state, you could interact. All we need, we change the environment and become plasma. So we should not lose no one in the process. But the beauty with this is that you are always used to matter. Now working in a gas environment, and then now working in a plasma environment, you have one freedom. Now with the plasma, you can choose where and what you want your plasma to be. Now you have a freedom which you didn't have before. You choose your plasma, in a given condition, you can get a gans, change it, you can get nanomaterial, change it, you can get solid matter. And that is the freedom which is now you have to understand. And that's where the beauty comes in. This is where we sit with the conversion, not talking about molecular or atomic or a gans, but a free plasma, which we have the freedom to decide what it's going to be. And when you work with the plasma at this level, plasma releases its energy as a gravitational magnetic field. Now you can do whatever you like with it. You decide the change. You decide where you want the other part to be. You want it here or you want it there. Because now you have a bigger knowledge, you understand the more part of the totality is irrelevant, because wherever it goes, the link is there. So start to understand the simplicity, and those who try to make it complicated are those who never understood, at least by making it complicated, they show they are intelligent. But the intelligence of the universe is simple, belongs to all of us. And this is what we do. You are happy.